Why you're wrong about zero-based indexing. And I know that this might be controversial. I know this might be the last video that I ever make on YouTube. But by the end, I know you're going to agree with me. So let's get right to the chase. Argument zero. Oh, wait. That's actually my first argument. No one counts like this. You're just pretending, you're just locked into the programmer brain if you think the reasonable place to start counting for a sequence of things is zero. For example, if you were teaching your kids to count, right? If you were teaching them to count, nobody starts off with doing something like,
okay, little Primogen, here we go, we're gonna count, here we go, it starts like zero, one, two.
No, you don't do that. You teach your kids to count one, two, three. Everybody does this all the time, everywhere. I've never seen in any of my kids' books, zero is where we're starting to count when we're thinking about learning and associating numbers with actual values in real life. Beyond that, zero isn't intuitive at all. It wasn't even around as a concept that we were using until like 300 BC in Babylon, and then India started actually doing things with it. Then it spread throughout the Islamic world. They had a bunch of great ideas about it too. And then finally Fibonacci sequences, by the way, sort of popularizes the idea in Europe with Liber Abaci, which I probably slaughtered the name for, but I probably can't read the book anyway, so that's fine. The point is, zero, as a concept, as a number, is less intuitive than the rest of the natural numbers. Or if you don't want to count zero as a natural number, that's fine too. But I'm just saying it definitely feels and acts different than all the other numbers. And so now you're saying, TJ, but what about C? Are you really going to say you're so much smarter and so much better than all the people who made C? No, they're way smarter than I am. But fortunately for me, they never said anything about indexing. C only talks about array subscripting. And so you're saying, what do you mean array subscripting? So this sort of idea is the subscript of, like, if you write a little A for array and you put a little zero on the bottom. That's the same thing. They're saying sort of like A sub zero is the same thing as A with the curly braces, right? Left and right with a zero inside. And how do I know this? Well, I read the specification. I mean, come on. You really think it's going to be a teach video without me breaking out the specification? 6.5.2.1 of the C specification, subsection 2 states that a postfixed expression followed by an expression in square brackets is a subscripted designation of an element of an array object for E1, left bracket, E2, right bracket. That is the E2th element of E1. Counting from zero. Okay, so there's no mention here of this concept of an index. It is specifically talking about this idea of subscripting on a C array. And what are C arrays? When we're operating on array subscript, we're saying that this is equivalent to the location, right? So we're looking up, we're dereferencing the location of the array plus the subscript. Or in English, right, we want to get the location of array plus subscript. So subscript is basically like the offset from the original memory location, because in C, your pointer is actually the array and the first value. So if you do the math here and you take an array and you say, I want to get the address of the first element, ugh, it just says, seems so gross to say first when you're also going to say zero. Well, then we do the math, we cut everything out, and we end up getting array as array. So this is why in C, it makes sense to use zero as the subscript or the offset of the array, because what we're doing is actually pointer arithmetic with an array that has no additional information. Arrays don't contain information about their size or the elements. It's just literally a pointer to a spot in memory. You can do all sorts of really bad things with pointer casting and everything else, but the main point is that the array is actually just pointing to that thing in memory. And so when we add zero to the array itself, we get back that array. But in higher level languages, this isn't the case. We have some container object, and we're not doing pointer arithmetic or messing around with the memory locations themselves. We have a list object, right? Or some sequence object. We can take, for example, this idea of then an index, not a subscript, right? So what we have here is we're not doing subscripting anymore. We want to point to, or we want to indicate what element we are trying to get inside of this sequence. And what's crazy here is we know that indexes are meant to point to things. That's what this is called, index finger, right here. I'm using my index finger to point to my index finger. And hear me out on this one. Hear me out on this one. How do we say one? We point like this. Coincidence? I think not. We use our index finger to point to one. So when you point at the first element, there is something you point at one. And if it were possible to point at the none or zero element, that would be pointing at zero. That's what indexes do. They point at things. And we can see this. This is the language that's used inside other programming languages. For example, if you think about Python, this get item dunder method is what happens when you use those subscript operators. Although in this case, they're sort of a get item operator. And it says for sequence types, the accepted key should be integer. So there's this concept of a key, right? And the key is what's pointing there. And what gets raised if there's an error is an index error. So what we can think about here is anything inside of these brackets, that's what we want to point to. So when we have some person dictionary or something like this, and we want to get the age out of that person, we pass the age value. And so then any reasonable person, I think, when they're saying get the first item, what are you going to put in the question mark spot? You're of course going to put one. It's only our tricked programmer brains, the big industrial C complex that is tricking you into thinking zero should go here. It doesn't matter if you have a complaint about the speed or the math or anything else like that, at least in Python, because you're already writing Python. You just can't complain about it, right? And what's great in a wonderful sort of twist of fate for me as I was doing this research, I was reading the error once again from the standard manual from index error in Python. And what it says that's so great is it says raised when a sequence subscript is out of range. And so within this problem in Python, which is zero based, there's this contrast, this contradiction that you raise an index error, but what you're actually talking about is a subscript. That's the mismatch that I'm saying. An index is not the subscript in this case, the way we're normally thinking and talking about these things. And beyond that, if we just appeal to our intuitions, well, come on. We know what number points to the first position. And we know what index we want to check when we're looking to see if we're in the first iteration of a loop. But beyond that, these are the ones that I think really, you really have to admit. What number points to the third position? Are you really going to tell me that when I ask what number points to the third position, your first thought is two? You're telling me you're not likely to accidentally do three instead of two when you're looking for the third thing in a tuple? Really, that's what we're going to say. And the other problem is that this zero-based sort of copied idea is not just for things that are strictly arrays, but we also end up using this thing for other data types too. When we're doing this, we lose the symmetry of having the last element equal the number of items. So how many times have you tried to get the last character or something like that in a string and you've forgotten to do length minus one? Right. And now we would be able to just say, I want to get the last character, my string of my string.length. We could just get it. We could just forget about all the times that we've made other mistakes because we just cargo culted the idea of zero into these strings as well. My last point here. If you're iterating over something, you're really going to tell me that this very lame indexing is better than just indexing from one to the length of the array. I know we're used to zero. I know you want to say, TJ, it doesn't matter. Zero is the right way because that's the way we do it. Stop trying to convince me otherwise. That's okay. I know that's why you're feeling, and that's why, in conclusion, all I have to say is, please stop arguing about this. This doesn't matter. You should just be using iterators. Oh, and one more thing. Lua was right. Brazil mentioned. Neovim, by the way. Thanks, everybody. And bye.